Om Sai Ram. SaiYugNetwork.com is a team of dedicated devotees of Lord Sai Baba who has come forward to make this Kali Yuga as Sai Yug. They have various network of blogs wherein recent experiences of devotees, history translations, spiritual ventures, divine discourses on Lord Sai Baba are shared and reached to masses around the globe. From 11 years, the service is being done via blogs and social media. Now they have entered this world of YouTube videos, especially for those who are unable to read write-ups shared. One can listen to experiences, translated stories, prayers, ventures, original bhajans, poems, quotes with beautiful pictures of Lord Sai Baba. Kindly subscribe to our channel and hit bell icon to get notification of our latest videos. Also like, share and comment to increase our encouragement. Devotedly presented by Sai Yug Network team.
Devotee experience with Sai Baba Part 1. Sai Devotee Rashmi. Sai sister Rashmi ji from India says, Dear Hetal ji, thank you very much for creating and maintaining this blog where we all can share our experiences. These posts have now become an integral part of our lives, which not only increase our faith manifolds on our Sadguru Shri Sai Nath, but work as a ray of hope in times of trouble. You truly are a blessed soul and may Baba continue to bless you and your family always. You have been kind enough to post my earlier mail on 1st April 2011, how Sai Baba saved our lives. Though the experiences have been unlimited, but I somehow could not pen them down. Now, Baba had made me write about some of his leelas and blessings. I thank all the readers in advance for their patience to read these long posts. You may share my name and email. Baba in my dream. It was the morning of 25th December 2010. I have a habit of keeping my mobile near me in bed as I put the alarm in it. That morning, I remember seeing the time 5:45 am and slept again as it was a holiday, and then started this most beautiful dream. I was in Baba's temple. Dhoop Aarti was about to start. Temple was quite crowded as on Thursdays. It was not particularly the same temple near my home, which I often visit, but similar one. Baba's idol was in center, open from all sides, and people were standing all around for Aarti. I was standing in a corner on the back side of Baba's idol, carrying a thick red book in my hands, perhaps Shri Sai Satcharitra, and the Aarti was printed on back. Soon Aarti started, and I realized that people started moving a little as if making space for someone to pass. I also started looking in their direction with curiosity. And Sai Baba himself was coming. Average height, old age, a thin lean figure in creamiest white attire. 2 to 3 men were escorting him. Baba was walking fast, but due to old age, not able to walk properly. He came to the middle and then turned. As soon as he reached in front of me, I quickly ran towards him, touched his feet and returned to my place. As Baba was walking fast and I suddenly came in his way, he slightly stumbled, took 2 to 3 steps forward, stopped and started looking at me angrily. I looked at him and started trembling with fear. The temple's priest, standing beside me, said, "Why did you do this? So many people are standing here. Did anyone try to come in Baba's way? Look how angry he is now." I, still trembling with fear, looked at him, and Baba took 2 to 3 steps towards me. As soon as I saw him moving towards me, I ran to him and bent on my knees. With book in my hands and tears in my eyes, I continued to look at him. Suddenly, Baba started smiling and put his hands on my head. He said something, which I cannot recollect. I started crying and put my head on his feet. Baba then moved further and was lost in the crowd. I got up and came back to my place. Aarti was going on, but I was not able to concentrate and was crying continuously. After Aarti, I noticed that my husband was entering the temple with my son. I ran towards him to narrate him the whole incident, and I woke up. When I woke up, I remembered the dream completely and was feeling such bliss and was actually crying. I was again and again closing my eyes, rewinding the whole dream to continue, feeling the divinity and Baba's presence. Till today, whenever I remember this dream, I feel Baba around. Offering Baba's dress on Vrat Udyapan. This beautiful Leela happened in February 2011. I was doing Sai Vrats and Udyapan was due on Thursday, 10th February. On Monday, 7th February, we went to take Baba's blessings, as it was my daughter's birthday. We brought a dress for Baba and wished that Baba should wear it on coming Thursday, my Udyapan day. We thought that the dress will be offered on my daughter's birthday and Baba will grace it on my Udyapan day. But the priest denied, saying that Thursday was fully booked. I was disappointed. Then I asked about it 17th February, my wedding anniversary. Actually, I wanted that Baba should wear this dress on a day which is somehow significant to me. Priest checked and said that possible, as 17th is free, but you take it back and bring it a day before 16th February. I was again not happy because I did not want to take it back. My husband then asked the priest that when Baba can wear it earliest. Priest replied, "Tomorrow, Tuesday, 8th February. My husband looked at me. Unwillingly, I agreed. But I was a little upset as 8th February had no significance for me. But taking it as Baba's will, we left the temple. Back home, my husband reminded that the next day, Tuesday, 8th February, we were to attend a wedding as well. As soon as he said this, tears started rolling from my eyes, seeing Baba's Leela. I had forgotten that it was Basant Panchami next day. The day Baba chose to wear our dress is also very important in my life, as my marriage took place on Basant Panchami. As per Hindu calendar, it was my marriage anniversary next day. A very significant day for me indeed. I was mesmerized by Baba's kind grace. Another very important thing connected with this dress was the color. When I was looking for a dress for our beloved Baba, I saw many of them. And the one which I bought finally was available in 3 colors: orange, magenta, and yellow. Though all were equally beautiful, but I liked yellow. Later, when I related everything, I realized why Baba made me buy yellow for him. He wanted to wear this dress on Basant Panchami, when yellow is very important. That's why I liked yellow among 3. Baba always listens to the smallest of our prayers and showers his blessings, even when we do not realize. plans for our Shirdi visit. We had visited Shirdi to take Baba's darshan in October 2008. Within 6 months of him taking us to his kind embrace, the visit was very comfortable and we had very good darshan also. But I always felt that somewhere something was missing during that visit. I always felt Baba nearer to me in Delhi, but while in Shirdi, I could not feel that nearness to him. After getting to know about this blog and reading all the experiences of other devotees, especially about their divine experience in Shirdi, a strong desire started to develop within me to visit Shirdi again. We were facing many problems in our personal and professional lives, like my husband's office, my son's falling sick too often, etc. But Baba kept us going. I had a belief that our problems will subside if we go to Shirdi. I often used to look for train tickets to Shirdi, as by air was beyond budget now. But AC coaches in train always showed full, and considering long journey, about 22 hours, I did not want to reserve in sleeper class. In September 2011, I was too depressed because of the problems. I again started surfing the railway website and could find tickets available for 4th December 2011. It was again sleeper class, but I was so anxious to go that I booked the tickets. Unfortunately, return journey could not be booked. I left it as it is, thinking that we will see when the time comes, as we would always have the option to return by air. In October, my husband changed his job to a better one. In third week of November, I realized that I will have to cancel the tickets, as my husband could not afford to take off for 3 to 4 days in his new job. I was too upset. Finally, with heavy heart and tears in my eyes, I cancelled the tickets. While cancelling, I promised to Baba that I will not take any sweets, anything made of sugar, honey or jaggery, until he calls us to Shirdi. I must admit that I have a sweet tooth, and living without sweets is something I could not imagine even my dreams. I don't know how and why it happened, but I made this promise and Baba made me fulfill the same. Om Sai Ram. I have a sister in Australia, a very staunch devotee of Baba. Actually, my guru sister, as she is not my sister by birth, but we were connected through Baba and he has tied us into this relation forever. Though we have never ever seen each other, but are very close to each other's heart, maybe because this connection was made by Baba. Whenever I feel low, she boosts me, strengthens my faith and gives immense courage to face all the problems in life. As there were various problems, I used to be upset and always thought of going to Shirdi. It seemed that a visit to Shirdi is the only solution to all those problems. Looking me so anxious, on 20th November 2011, my sister from Australia got Baba's reply through question answers site that your work will be done on Guru Purnima day in July. She immediately asked me to check the tickets for July. Guru Purnima was on 3rd July 2012. It was too early to check for the tickets, as booking opens 4 months in advance. But July seemed not so appropriate to me because of the terrible weather in July, and secondly that schools in Delhi reopen in beginning of that month after summer vacations. I left it on Baba. Then on 17th April 2012, I was again too upset and tried speaking to Baba through the same website. I was asking him why he is not calling us to Shirdi, how long do we need to suffer, etc. and miraculously I got the same answer there. Your work will be done on Guru Purnima day. It was astonishing. Two persons, me and my sister, two different places, Delhi and Melbourne. Two different dates, 20th November 11, 2011 and 17th April 2012, asked Baba same question and he gave the same reply. I immediately checked the tickets which were again not available. Then Guru Purnima day came on 3rd July 2012. I was working in my office and suddenly opened the railway website. Tickets were available for return journey for October through air in sleeper class. October seemed fine to me to travel even in sleeper class as the weather would be okay. At the same time, my sister in Australia thought of checking for tickets and sent me a SMS. In the evening, I consulted with my husband. Baba made us reserve the tickets for 10th October 2012 immediately. I was jumping with happiness. It may seem a small thing to others, but for me, it was like the dream of my life, which was going to come true. Though there were many hiccups again about leave from our offices, our son's health, weather conditions, long journey, etc. But Baba ensured everything this time, and the visit did happen. I have drafted my experiences in Shirdi in a separate post, which I hope will be posted tomorrow. And with Baba's kind grace, I started eating sweets after 11 months with his prasad in Shirdi. At the end, I would just like to say that Baba is very kind. He does listen to our prayers, takes care of our slightest wishes, but as he always said that, we have to bear the results of our karmas. I pray to him to keep us always near to his holy feet. Om Sai.
Please visit our blog video.saiyugnetwork.com. For experiences, please visit shirdisaibabaexperiences.org. For stories, please visit shirdisaibabastories.org. For bhajans, please visit shirdisaibabhajans.com. For our Hindi blog, please visit hindiblog.saiyugnetwork.com. For submitting your experiences or prayers, please visit submit.saiyugnetwork.com. For more details, please visit our website saiyugnetwork.com. Please check, we have shared all links in comment sections here as well.
Ananta koti brahmand nayak raja dhiraj yogi raj parabrahma Shri Satchidananda Sadguru Sai Nath Maharaj Ki Jai.